It's a pleasure to welcome Natalia Kavchuk, a woman chameleon-like in her ever-growing list of talents, from catwalk model to businesswoman, actress, TV presenter, and now an artist. Seriously, how do you do it?
How do I do it? Just follow me and you will know how I do it.
Oh, I like that. I like that. So let's get a little understanding about your background. You were born in Russia. You live between Dubai and London. How has immersing yourself simultaneously in these two cultures helped to shape your diverse professional career?
Yes, basically, I moved from Siberia 10 years ago and it's a big difference from minus 30 to plus 30 and 40, and I love Dubai, and I love the weather, and I love people here. It's so international. So I didn't plan to stay here for a long time. So part of my family lived here, so I joined them, and now I'm here 10 years. But basically between Dubai and London. But I love both. They're so different. So it's nice to travel here and there. Like today I'm leaving to London just in a couple of hours.
Oh yeah, wow, you really are a girl jet setting. So it's a real mix then between the colour, the style, the scenery, and as you say, the climates of mixing between your growing up in Russia and living between London and Dubai.
Yeah, and I'm travelling a lot. I think I'm travelling once a week or once in 2 weeks.
Incredible. As you said,
I just can't stop, you know?
You brought your suitcase to the studio. You're literally off in a couple of hours to London.
Yeah.
Oh, living the life.
Exactly. I packed for like 4 months, so it's a lot of luggage.
So as you just mentioned, Natalia, you moved to Dubai 10 years ago, modeling for big time brands and designers. This includes Messini, Roberto Cavalli, Dolce & Gabbana, Cartier. And to think it all started when you won Miss Siberia pageant as a teenager. How's that feel?
It was amazing. I was actually 13, 14 years old. I was walking on the street with my mom and one designer stopped me and she asked me if I can model for her fashion show. So I said, why not? And then my mom, she gave me to the studio to learn catwalk. And then at the age of 14, I won regional beauty pageant competition. And then at the age of 16, Miss Siberia. So that's how it all started, then my modeling career. And then life brought me to Dubai and I continued doing it, and then also business aspect I brought into my life as well.
But you were born to do it. Those legs, they're endless. You've been blessed.
I should be in a Guinness book for the length of my legs.
They're gorgeous. I just said, I'm so glad you didn't wear heels today or I'd look even more midget next to you than I do already. We are live on Instagram, Dance FM UAE. I'll be right back with Natalia after this new one from Disciples. It's called 48 Hours. This is The Vibe.
Beats and bloggers. Stay with Gemma as she gets the latest from the UAE's biggest influencers.
Continuing my chat with Natalia. So after you achieved modelling fame here in the UAE, you actually had a career transition onto the TV scene, becoming host of Fashion TV Dubai.
Yes, right.
And now this was actually the start of your TV career. You were on the TV show Meet the Russians, BFF Paris Hilton.
Right.
As well as the blockbuster Switch. So what did you prefer, the catwalk or TV screen?
I like both, but I think I had so much of catwalk and photo shoots, so this transition was kind of organic. And I really enjoyed it, and I went to LA, I started acting, and it was quite an amazing experience.
Is this what led you to then, in 2015, you absolutely rocked Bollywood with the song Tipsy Ho Gay?
Right.
Now, and that was in the movie Girlfriend.
Dili Wale Zaleem, Girlfriend. It's a Hindi movie, and I was offered a role in the music video. It's an item song, and it became a big hit in India. It was in the charts. So
5 million plus views on YouTube.
Yes,
that's
right.
Massive.
Yeah, I can do it.
So how did the project come about to collaborate on that?
So I was offered, like, Natalia, can you do it? I'm like, I don't know Hindi, but yeah, I can do it. So I was taking in Skype lessons with a teacher.
Really?
For 1 month. And then I was learning Bollywood dancing. And it was an amazing experience, I should say. And and I'm happy I said yes to that project.
I bet. I mean, what an experience, and so different from all your other TV projects. This Bollywood, I'm in awe. That would have been awesome.
I was always attracted to Bollywood because I was growing up on these movies in Russia. All these Indian movies are so popular, and they're always appealing to me. So I was very happy to do it. Yeah, exactly. I couldn't believe I can be a part of it.
And your latest endeavor. Now, this is becoming an established artist. You're using paints as your medium. And you say this has been a calling from your soul.
Actually, my mom is an artist and a sculptor, and I studied art. And then I gave up. I thought, like, no, I don't want to be an artist. There is no money in there. So I studied international relations after that. And then a couple of years ago, I realized something is missing in my life. And I went and I got paints and I started painting. And then I just couldn't stop.
So your mom, you said, is a sculptor?
A sculptor and an artist. She's an art teacher.
Yeah. Oh, okay. And you tried your hand at sculpting, but paint's
more your
forte.
Yeah, I was doing it. Yeah, and then I started modeling, and then I gave up on that.
But now you're back to it.
Now I'm back.
Maybe it needed that little time to marinate in your subconscious. So now,
exactly. I'm back to my roots.
And you said it's really, you're using your first-hand experience of the Western and Eastern worlds with your contemporary style. So it's vivid colors, a lot of pop culture in your work.
Yeah, I do pop culture because I'm traveling a lot, so I'm getting inspired with the culture that's happening now. I love street art, so I do lots of, I use spray paint, I love colors, so I do mixed media, collage, so I like to mix things and to do experiments.
Is your mom your art teacher?
Her style is completely different to mine, okay. But she's very supportive.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, maybe it's best to keep it as mum and daughter, and then you have an outsider to coach you. And you've also got plans to open a gallery.
Right, exactly. I'm planning to open a gallery and a hub for up-and-coming artists where they come and paint and exchange the ideas and collaborate together.
Are you still settling which location, Dubai or London?
So it started with Dubai, so I'm still deciding where I'm going to do it because I might spend more time in London.
Oh, I can't wait. We'll keep track. Thank you so much, Natalia Kubchuk, for coming on the show.
It was nice talking to you.
Safe flight tonight.
Thank you.
Watch our full Beats and Bloggers interview on dancefm.com. This is a Calvin Buckley remix of Sean Paul, Breathe, on 97.8 Dance FM.